my hair loss started about 10 years ago. But it started with a very small bald patch, and I couldn't really notice it in the mirror myself. So I kind of just brushed my hair over it and forgot about it. When I was 26, I fell pregnant. After Lily was born, a lot more started falling out. Biscuit crisps or some fruit?
Biscuits. Actually, crisps. Thank you.
It was quite drastic and quite fast. And this left me nearly bald in places.
This is an interesting one from Anne-Marie. She's telling me that she's got hair loss and it's been thinning for the last 10 years. Oh gosh, this poor lady. She's got polycystic ovarian syndrome. She's got thyroidism. She's had a gastric bypass. A lot going on with this lady.
Do you mind just taking your hair down for me so I can have a look and we can discuss a little bit more? Is that all right?
Yeah, that's okay, because I did have a hair piece in, which I had taken out.
Yep.
And the hairdresser just popped this on so that I can walk out the salon not feeling too embarrassed.
Oh, bless you. And thank you for taking the piece off, because I wouldn't be able to see with it on. In terms of the hair system that you wear, are you happy with that? Or are you looking for something different?
Since wearing it, I've noticed where, you know, it's not perfect. It grows out as well. So after a couple of weeks, my normal hair grows and it lifts up.
Yeah.
So then I have to go back, have it all taken off and re-tightened.
And how long does that take?
Oh, that takes about 3 or 4 hours. So it's really time consuming. It's not painful, it's just uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I'd definitely be interested if there was another way of doing things.
Okay. You've been on quite a journey in the last few years, haven't you? You've got a thyroid condition, low thyroid, hypothyroidism.
Yep. Yep.
I've just reviewed your bloods.
Right.
At the moment, the sort of TSH, the thyroid stimulating hormone, that's a little bit high. Because you've also had major gastric surgery, haven't you?
Yes,
when did you
have
that done?
I had that about 18 months ago. My hair loss got a lot worse directly after it.
Yep.
I do take a lot of supplements that I have to keep vitamin levels up.
And you've also got polycystic ovarian syndrome.
I do get symptoms from that, other symptoms.
Yeah, what kind of symptoms do you get?
So I suffer with excess hair in the places
I don't want it. You don't want it, yeah. All of those things you're telling me, they all have a direct impact on the hair.
Yes.
Have you ever lost any hair anywhere else? Sort of eyebrows, eyelashes, body hair?
No, nothing.
No.
I have too much hair everywhere else.
Yeah.
Apart from my head.
Apart from your head, which
it's almost
unfair.
Like I'm turning into a man.
Well, let's see what we've got, and then we can have a chat about what I'm finding and we'll see what options we've got open. Is that all right?
That sounds great.
So we've got hair follicles and hair. That's what we're looking at. Can you see the flakes there?
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, it's a little bit inflamed. Does it get quite itchy underneath the system?
Extremely itchy.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, what's that?
Yeah, that's just the flakes and the redness. There's some where you've sort of had a little pick.
Yeah.
I think we've got three different conditions going on. The first is your hair shedding. So when you're noticing it in the brush, in the shower. And this is definitely down to your gastric bypass.
Okay.
I've had a gastric bypass.
Oh,
so I had mine 10 years ago. Yeah.
Wow, okay.
And my hair tells me long before anything else does to really have a look at what I'm eating.
Right.
So I think working with you on diet and the right supplements to take will really help to get that bit sorted. The second thing we've got is a scalp condition, what we call seborrheic dermatitis. What we can do today is I can give you a quick scalp treatment to just calm that scalp down, and then we can get you on a treatment shampoo to use that's going to balance that. And then we've got androgenetic alopecia. So it comes in female pattern and male pattern. You've got more of a tendency to have the male pattern. I see ladies that have been to dermatologists and been told you've got male pattern hair loss, and they're devastated because it takes your femininity away.
Definitely.
And it just means the way it's presenting is typically the way a male hair loss would present.
Okay.
Gastric bypass is a huge emotional investment, and she'd got a huge down because her hair got even worse. So to try and embrace that kind of emotional up that losing some of that excess weight gives you must have been really tough to go through.
Okay, so there's two treatments we're going to use. One is going to help the scalp to calm, and then the other one is a treatment on the hair to just make it a little bit more hydrated and softer. So this has got cade oil and salicylic acid in it. Salicylic acid is often used in facials. People forget the scalp is skin, so yeah. It'll take those excess skin cells off. So that's the treatment on. What I'm going to do is pull the steamer over and I'm going to bake you for 10 minutes. Is that okay?
That's fine. Yes.
Lovely. Oh, that looks a lot calmer on there.
Does
already.
It? Wow.
Yeah. And last but not least is looking at some kind of hair system. The integration that you're using is not the kindest thing to the hair, you know. The tugging and the tension underneath can cause it to thin more. So I wondered if you'd consider something like this. It might not be for you. It doesn't matter if it isn't. It's very, very light. When you look through it, you can see it's see-through. It's got a crown, a fringe.
Can't really see what I'm doing.
But the important thing is the way it fits. And it won't put that tension on, and your head will breathe. The place that makes these, they'll help you with the hairline, with the styling, how to put it on, how to take it off.
Yeah.
The best way to find your hairline is to put your four fingers together, just bring it forward to where your finger is. That's it. That's your natural hairline, yeah.
Wow, that's
a
good trick.
That's a good little trick, isn't it? It only works with your own fingers.
I've not seen myself like that for a long time. It's just, amazing. Hair on my head, what's going on?
How would it feel to wear something like that that Lily could style for Mummy? How would that make you feel?
I think that'd be amazing. I think it would bring me and her closer together, and I think she'd really appreciate it. That's really opened my eyes.
Great, that's really makes me happy that we've kind of got a plan and a way forward.
The next steps for me is to follow the treatment that Eva's given me and look into the different hair systems that she showed me.
Guess for Anne-Marie, I wanted to embrace her femininity. You know, she's been through a lot, she's had gastric surgery, she wants to wear great clothes, she wants makeup, she wants hair. We're facilitating that and making it possible, and you know, I wanted to go out there and strut her stuff like any other woman does. Got to catch up with Anne-Marie today. She arrived with a
androgenetic alopecia male pattern.
And she's also got a seborrheic dermatitis. The hair piece was really, really not helping her hair and scalp. And it was impossible to treat with it because it was permanently stuck on her head. We've worked to get that hairpiece removed and a high quality wig put in its place. It allows Anne-Marie to start treating. Come on in.
How have you found the wig?
It's just so much more comfortable. I'm not, before, I don't know if you remember, I was sort of wedging my fingers into scratch. I love it.
Shall we have a little look and see what we've got? What's quite good, Anne-Marie, is that I'm seeing some new hair growth, and I'm also seeing a better density of hair as well. And I think visually there's a difference.
So this was back in November, but there's lots of these miniaturised hairs, really fine, hardly visible. And now what you've got is a much more even density. A lot of the hairs are thicker, fuller, more even. So that's what's visually making it look thicker and fuller.
The first image looks like grass and the second looks like a forest.
Oh, bless you.
I'm speechless. I can't believe there's a difference.
Keep doing what you're doing, and I'm really pleased. It's a really, really good result today.